What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another K-pop music video reacts. Today, I'm reacting to NCT127's Favorite Vampire, and I really should have reacted to this before Halloween, but better late than never. They just put out a new video on October 25th, and I thought, why not throw in some K-pop boy groups with all of the girl groups that I've been reacting to. Pixie, Dreamcatcher, Twice, ITZY, aespa, all of the girl groups, but I don't give enough love to the guy groups. So today I'm giving some love to the boy groups. I saw the genre as K-pop, hip-hop, R&B, so it's gonna be a little bit different from what I've been listening to. I've been listening to a lot of Dreamcatcher. It's a little bit more rock and electronic inspired. So this is gonna be interesting. It's gonna be different. I saw a little piece of the video before and it looked like it's very visually eye grabbing. So I'm excited to watch that. So let's just get to it. Stop wasting time. Let's get to the reaction. English subtitles as usual. Favorite vampire. Now, before we even start, who's my favorite vampire? Probably Damon Salvatore from Vampire Diaries. Great vampire. Okay, now that I've embarrassed myself, let's get to this reaction.
You're my favorite girl.
Oh, okay.
Your bill got you dug up. I'm your mom. She can't be afraid at all.
Jeez. Oh my god.
Quit that. Hands down. Take that.
Oh. There's so much stuff going on. I don't even know how to process this.
Satisfy my soul. No, not in that a mole. Jump me no burgundy. See that. Yardy Jin and a nail. Hands down. Shinjak is your gangland girl. Take that. Eat a good game bomb. No, what a day gone. Got a dude.
I love the jackets. It's very like Michael Jackson.
Okay.
Where did this come from? I'm like taken aback. This video is a lot. I do love this chorus though.
Yeah.
Vampire. So, right off the bat, wow. There was a lot going on. Usually, at least in my opinion, in some music video, most K-pop music videos, they have like 1 to 2 to maybe like 4 at max different sets or different scenes. But even in like the first, I think like 30 seconds, they go through, it feels like 10. I don't know. We can watch again and see how many there are. The bridge, I don't know how hot I'm how hot I am about the bridge with like the dance break where it's just like totally very, very different. But I don't know if it fits. Maybe it's just the first listen that got me shook. But we'll listen and see if we can digest. We need to digest this one more time. I do love this, that whistle throughout the whole thing. You think like a persisting like melody like that would get annoying, but I don't know. I think they put it in the right spaces where it's not annoying. It doesn't get too tired. I don't really know what the story is. They're vampires. Like, and I love that little she. Very, very topical, I guess. But this, even just this like transition, you go in, the butterfly goes in the dude's mouth. I don't know names. There's 10 of them. I'm sorry, I don't know. It goes in this guy's mouth, and I think it comes out the other guy's eye. Yeah, like, I still love that. They go through like all of their scenes. Like usually you'd have a transitions would be different, I guess, in the second half of the song and then the bridge and then maybe come back for the chorus. But it feels like they literally just show you all of their scenes in the first like 30 seconds. So we got like this. Then there's this one. That one. Then there's that middle one. I don't know, I guess that's the woods. Then the bathroom. Take that. I totally think this is a missed opportunity where they sort of focus on his vampire bite and they don't go in the vampire bite to transition. I thought that would have been a cool transition. And then you just go like... And like with for 10 guys singing, it's not too crowded in the chorus. It's like, I don't know how maybe some of them aren't singing because that would be a lot of people singing at once. But I don't know. I just love this chorus. I love all of their voices stacked on top of each other. And I think the second part of the chorus is better. Yeah, so I like, so in the first part of the chorus is just kind of their normal singing, but then if I think we'll have to listen to it again. It keeps getting a little bit higher and higher, and it just building, it feels like momentum. Maybe it's just the rhythm. Then there's this scene, we haven't seen this yet. Just watch
satisfy my soul.
And there's this, there was this, he's just in stars.
Just watching you never satisfy my soul. See that.
I love that rhythm. It's good. Then all the butterflies turn into, it looks like rose petals. I don't know the significance of that. Without regrets. Okay, and so this is just a very, it's just very different. And the transition, I don't know if I like it. The instrumentation's very different. And then it's just like, don't get me wrong, it's interesting, but it's just like, the whole song was kind of, it was like hip hop R&B. Then this bridge or dance break is literally just like, let's throw a lot of dubstep sounds in. And I don't know if it fits well together. Like, it's interesting. It's mixed well. But and then it just goes. It feels very off. And then this scene. So this is like the bridge. I guess that was a dance break. When he's like evaporating into the rose petal. So cool. And then the classic, you know, I missed this. I missed, you know, the very subtle music and then just like the talking where it's like, girl, it reminds me of like old school, I guess it's old school Backstreet Boys, where it's like, girl, you know that you got me. I can't even lie. It's cheesy, but it's good. It works. I love it. And then I love this last chorus. This last chorus is really, really cool because I like, they kind of actually used parts in that dance break, the percussion. It feels like the drum line. And then I don't think there's that much else in this chorus. Yeah, that drum. Yeah, I love that whistle. Really cool. That was a lot. So that was NCT127's Favorite Vampire. Really, really fun video. There was a lot to process. I'm still sort of, my brain is still kind of, you know, deprocessing and processing it, trying to just put it all together. The music was great. I still kind of think that dance break was a little just like little out of place, but it was it still didn't lessen my enjoyment of the whole song. Really, really fun. They've definitely got a new fan in me, and now I'm gonna have to go back and watch everything that they've done, which is probably a lot because they've been around for what is it, 5 years? So that's a lot of music video. That's a lot of more, that's more K-pop. But that means, you know what that means? That means more YouTube content. Let me know what you thought of this video, if it's one of their best, or if there are even better ones that they've done in the past, and I can go and react to those. That's very exciting. I'm excited to just, I'm adding more groups, which is kind of anxiety inducing to try and juggle all of these groups eloquently and try to put out videos for all of their old stuff and that. But if it's great music, I just don't care. If it's great music, I gotta listen to it. I gotta react to it. And that's the bottom line. Also, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe button, and the notification bell to stay up to date so that you'll be notified when a new video goes live. The next video should be TWICE's Scientist. Very excited. TWICE is my top group. Nobody's gonna ever beat out TWICE. Nobody. Nobody. And so I'm very excited to react to Scientist. I'm very excited for Flavor of Love. I got a couple of albums pre-ordered, so maybe I'll do an unboxing video on camera. Maybe in the comments you can say if that would be something you'd like to see. You can see all of the stuff that I got. This was fun. This is a very fun video, very fun song. Definitely gonna add it to my K-pop playlist. So until the next video, which will be TWICE's Scientist, I hope you all have a great day.